Hello friend, in today's video we will learn how to connect this soil moisture sensor with Raspberry Pi. Also we will use DC motor and relay. So use of DC motor and relay is that whenever the soil moisture sensor detect the water, then automatically this DC motor stop rotating, and as soon as this soil moisture sensor does not detect the water, then this relay will turn on, and with the help of this relay this DC motor will turn on. So we will simulate all this project in this video. So let's see what will be the final output first of this project. Okay, when we start our project, you can see soil moisture sensor present inside water, so that this relay will not turn on. You can see the LED of the relay is switch off. Also the DC motor is not rotating. Once I remove the soil moisture sensor from this water, then this automatically relay will turn on and this DC motor start rotating. Okay, now I will remove the soil moisture sensor from this water so that this DC motor start rotating. So you can see as soon as I remove the soil moisture sensor from the water, this DC motor start rotating and relay also turn on. Also again I will place the soil moisture sensor inside that water, then DC motor stop rotating. So we will learn how to create this project in this video. So I request you please watch this complete video so that you will get idea about hardware connection also and Python programming. So before start the next part, I request you please subscribe my channel. You can see currently I have 365 subscriber, and to verify my channel on YouTube, you can see I require 1000 subscriber and 4000 watch hour. So this only possible because of you. So please subscribe my channel so that once you click on the subscribe button and click on the like button, it will motivate me and I will create a more video on Raspberry Pi. So currently you can see I have created more than 30 to 40 video on Raspberry Pi. The video starting from the LED, that is very basic, till the IoT protocol. So if you want to learn the Raspberry Pi from me, then please watch my video. Please watch my each and every video. So once you click on the subscribe button, you will get notification as soon as I upload the video. Okay, first hardware is soil moisture sensor. So when you order this soil moisture sensor from the Amazon, then you can see these two components you will get. So for this one is actually soil moisture sensor, and this one is soil moisture sensor driver. So basically soil moisture sensor has two pins. There is no specification of this two pin. You can connect any one of this pin to any one of this side. So you can have this two pin. So first part is whenever you order, you have to first connect this two pin to this two at this side. So first connect this two pin here. Okay, once you connect these two pins at this side, it is the input side of this soil moisture sensor, and the output side we will connect to the Raspberry Pi. So you can see at the output side there is one potentiometer and there are four pins. So basically the use of this potentiometer is that you can adjust the sensitivity of this soil moisture sensor. So if you want to take the high sensitivity, then you can move that potentiometer to right side. If you want to give the low sensitivity, then you can move that this potentiometer to left side. Next part, you can see there are four pins. So first pin is VCC, then second is ground, then D out and analog out. So basically VCC pin is nothing but the power input pin to this soil moisture sensor, and ground pin is ground pin of this soil moisture sensor. So you can connect the VCC pin to 3.3 volt of the Raspberry Pi and the ground pin to the ground pin of Raspberry Pi. We can see later where is the ground pin and where is the VCC pin. The next part is D out and analog pin. So basically soil moisture sensor can give you two types of output. One is digital output, one is analog output. So basically analog output vary in the range of 0 to 1023. So you can do your code depending on the analog input, and there is digital in output also. So we have two choice, either we can go with analog input, analog output, or digital output. So in case if you select the analog output in your project, then you required one external circuit, that is MCP3208 IC, because Raspberry Pi do not have inbuilt MCP3208 IC. So if you want to go with analog output, then you can you have to use MCP3208 IC. We will see how to connect that MCP3208 IC with Raspberry Pi later. Okay, next component is relay. You can order this relay from the Amazon or from the Flipkart. In my model there are four relay. In case you have one relay also, then it is okay. So it depending upon your application how many type of relay you want. So you can see each for each relay there are 3 pins: ground, then VCC, then input. So in this case I have 4 relay, so that I have 4 input pins. So in your case, if you order the 1 relay or 2 relay circuit, then you can have 1 or 2 input pin at this side. So at the output side you can see there are 3 pins for each relay. So this pin is called as open load and this pin is called as closed load. So what is mean by closed load and open load? So whenever you give 1 signal or 0 signal depending upon your relay operation. So in this case my relay will turn on when I send the 0 signal to this relay board, because it is work on active low logic. So in your case, if your relay is work on active high logic, then you have to send the 1 signal at the input side, then and then only this relay will turn on. Okay, so once this relay will turn on, then this open load circuit get closed, so that these 2 pins, middle one pin and this pin, get short circuit, and with this we can complete our circuit and then our DC motor will start rotating. Okay, next component is Raspberry Pi. You can see I have used Raspberry Pi 3B. So you can use Raspberry Pi 4 also or Raspberry Pi 3 also. So you can see Raspberry Pi has 40 pins, 1 to 40. So odd number of pins of this Raspberry Pi come at this side only, and even number of pins comes at this side only. So if you want to see odd number of pins start point, so you can see this is a power of this Raspberry Pi, and whatever the pin at this side of power is one number of pin, and one number, then 3, then 5, then 7, then 9, then 11. So odd number pin come here, then 2, then 4, then 6, then 8, then 10, then even number pin come here. So this is very important to identify which pin come at which side. So I request you can also create such pin connection and paste your pin connection at the Raspberry Pi pin, so that you can easily identify pin number. So first we connect the relay board to Raspberry Pi. You can see relay has ground, VCC and input pin. So we will connect ground and VCC and input pin to Raspberry Pi. So first take the ground pin to Raspberry Pi ground pin. So you can see this is the ground pin of relay, and we will connect ground pin to Raspberry Pi. Six number pin is Raspberry Pi ground pin, so I have connected to 6 number pin here. Now next part is VCC pin of relay. You can see this is the VCC pin, and this VCC pin should be connected to VCC pin of Raspberry Pi. So this pin should be connected to 1 number of pin, 2 number of pin of Raspberry Pi, because 2 number is plus 5 voltage VCC pin. Now third point is you have to connect the input pin of relay to Raspberry Pi input pin, Raspberry Pi pin. So input pin from this relay, that is IN1, is connected to 7 number pin of Raspberry Pi, because 7 number pin act as a GPIO pin, so that we will connect 7 number 2 pin. Okay, now next point is we have to connect the DC motor to output side of relay 1. So you can see we will use first this middle one pin. So the one point of this DC motor should be connected to middle one of this pin. Okay, now next point, this pin, open collector pin, should be connected to Raspberry Pi VCC pin. So 4 number pin is nothing but the Raspberry Pi VCC pin. So again we will take this pin to 4 number pin. So connect this pin to 4 number again. So connect this pin to 4 number. Okay, now next point is we have to connect the another point of this DC motor to ground pin of Raspberry Pi. So I have one female to female connector. So this pin should be connected to ground pin. So ground pin of Raspberry Pi is nothing but the 39 number pin. So I have connected that pin to 39 number. Okay, so in this way we have completed the DC motor and relay part of this circuit. So next part is we will connect soil moisture sensor to Raspberry Pi. So you can see soil moisture sensor. First we have to connect the VCC pin from soil moisture sensor to Raspberry Pi 3.3 pin. So connect the VCC pin from soil moisture sensor to Raspberry Pi 3.3 pin. That is one number pin from Raspberry Pi. So VCC pin should be connected to one number pin of Raspberry Pi. Okay. Now next part is we have to connect the ground pin of the soil moisture sensor to Raspberry Pi ground pin. So connect this ground pin to Raspberry Pi ground pin. That is nine number pin. Okay. Now next part is we have to connect the D-out pin from the soil moisture sensor to Raspberry Pi GPIO pin. So D-out pin to, let's consider GPIO pin number 11. So we will connect this pin to 11 number pin. Okay. So after you connect all the sensor, all the relay and DC pin to Raspberry Pi, next part is you have to provide the power. So to provide the power, we will use this adapter, 5 volt 2 ampere adapter. You can use a mobile charger also. So we will connect that mobile charger to Raspberry Pi. If you are using the monitor, just connect your monitor HDMI to Raspberry Pi HDMI cable. So after that we will turn on our power supply. Okay, let's we will see how to create a new program into Raspberry Pi and how to run that program. After that we will see importance of each and every line from our program. So if you want to create a new program on Raspberry Pi, just right click on the desktop, then create a empty file. Use the file name with respect to your project. Let's say for our project we will give file name soil moisture sensor. So give that file name here and save that file with .py. Click on OK. So once you save that file with .py, that file save with Python. So after that double click on this file. Once you double click on this file, the soilmoisture.py file will be open. Now you can write your code here. Now we will see importance of each and every line from this program. Okay, first line is from time inputs sleep. So if you want to create some delay in your Raspberry Pi project, so you can use this time library with a sleep package. Then after that import raspberrypi.gpio. So when you want to use some GPIO code from Raspberry Pi, then you have to take the permission from Raspberry Pi. So to take the permission, we can use this import raspberrypi.gpio. This is the name, this is nothing but the package, GPIO package of Raspberry Pi. Next line is gpio.setMode gpio board. So basically Raspberry Pi works as a two method, Raspberry Pi board or Raspberry Pi BCM chip. So if you want to use a Raspberry Pi complete board, then you can use this line. Now next line is gpio.setWarning to the false. So whenever you run the code, Raspberry Pi gives you warning that whatever the GPIO pin you have used is already used before. So to avoid that warning, you should use this line. After that, relay pin to the 7. So during the circuit design, we have seen that the relay pin is connected to 7 number pin. So that we have defined here relay pin to the 7. Next line is soil sensor pin 11. So in circuit we also seen that soil sensor is connected to 11 number pin. So that we have connect, we have given here soil sensor pin to 11 number. Now next line is we have to set that pin as input or output. So soil sensor basically send the data to Raspberry Pi. So this pin act as a input pin. So that we have to declare this pin as our input pin. And relay pin is nothing but the Raspberry Pi send some output on the relay port. So that this pin act as a output pin. So to declare any pin as output or to input, we will use this line gpio.setup, pin name gpio.out or gpio.in. So by using these two lines, we have declared relay pin as output and soil sensor pin as input. Now next line is while true. So basically whatever the code inside this while true, it will execute infinite number of time. So first line is gpio.input soil sensor. So whenever Raspberry Pi want to sense any input from the sensor, this gpio.input function will be used. Basically gpio.input function used only for the binary logic, that is 1 or 0. That means the sensor should send 0 or 1 to Raspberry Pi. So in that case only we will use this function gpio.input. So gpio.input soil sensor. So whatever the input present on the soil sensor output pin, that will sense by using this line. So whatever the data present on the soil sensor, that will store on the moisture output variable. So if the moisture output variable is true, means there is no water. So if there is no water, then soil sensor send the one signal and we are checking if moisture output is equal to 1.
So is equal to once means there is no water. Then we have to print motor on no water on our desktop window. Then gpr.output relay pin gpr.low. Then we have to turn on the relay. So to turn on the relay, we have to use gpr.output relay pin gpr.low. So basically gpr.output pin send 1 or 0 signal on Raspberry Pi with respect to their this input. So in this case gpr.low. So we are sending 0 signal on the relay pin. So my relay is work on the active low logic. So whenever I send the 0 signal, then relay will turn on. So in this way, we'll turn on our relay when water is not present. So in case if water is present, then else part will execute and it will print motor on motor. So it will execute motor off, water present. Then we have to turn off the relay. So to turn off the relay, we have to send the high signal on relay pin. To send the high signal on relay pin, again we have to use gpr.output relay pin gpr.high. So in this way the relay will turn off and automatically motor will turn off. So if you want to run your code, just go to your code. Let's say I have saved my code at this location. Just right click on this code and copy path. Go to black window, that is this one, black terminal. Here should be Raspberry Pi terminal should come. So this is Raspberry Pi terminal. Then type Python and then right click and paste here. So once you paste here, so you can see press enter. So once you press enter, the Python code will start working. So it say there is no water. So once I place my soil moisture sensor inside water, then it will give motor stop and water present. Again I remove, then motor on, no water. So in this way you can run your code and you can try to execute this project so that you will learn more thing about Raspberry Pi.